everyone can help you, man. Yeah. But I can prove it under your credit card.
I just did.
Dude, I didn't see your name until just
there
now.
There I go right there.
May I hold them and look
no,
at
sir,
them?
No, sir.
Then prove to me that the rest of those cars are yours with your
oh,
name
they
on.
Are. All of my name on
them. Absolutely.
I'm in a hurry. My wife down there, she broke down.
I just want to see the cars.
There they go.
Hang on, let's make sure, man. Ryan.
Yeah, that's mine. Here.
Okay, that's one. You've got like 10 there, man.
All of them is mine.
Okay,
all
I understand
them.
That.
All of them.
I'm just trying to slow down
all
for
those
me.
Are mine.
Okay. Well, there's more there, man.
They're mine. They're mine,
listen, I'm
sir.
Not trying to make this more difficult than
sir,
it is, but
they're mine. They're mine. That's all. Okay. They're mine. Look, I got the same two cars. That's mine.
Okay.
Thank you.
But you understand why we're even talking with you?
I got you.
Pardon?
I got you.
Okay.
No, I had the wrong pin in some of my cars. I got to go on my phone and unlock it.
Okay.
So that's why I was switching
cars. See, that's reasonable. Yeah. That makes sense. Because, you know.
Yeah, I got my kids on my account, so I got different the same cars. You
okay.
Know?
So you have, because I know you're with Navy Federal yeah. Credit Union, right? Yeah. So you have like 10 different cards from them?
I got my kids on account.
Yeah.
And I got myself on account, and me and my wife is on account.
Gotcha. Okay. Again, we're only asking you this because somebody brought to our attention. Gotcha. They were concerned, and that's why we're going to talk with
I mean,
you.
They could have asked me, or I mean,
keep
you know,
in mind this. Some people, they don't look at things like, hey, I'm going to stop this guy or ask this guy a question. They want us to handle that because they don't feel like it's their business for them to come up to you. Does that make sense? Because if you saw somebody doing something like that, would you say something to them? You'd probably come and find us and say, hey,
My wife down there broke down, so I'm trying to get
where she broke down at?
Way down there off of Crowley.
Oh, Crowley?
Well, that was the street that is. I'm not from here. I don't know.
Oh, how'd you end up in Burleson?
Because I'm getting a tattoo over here.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
Okay, is that what you're drawing money out for?
Yes.
Okay, you gonna go help your wife?
Yes, I'm gonna get to her first.
Okay, I got you. Just bear with us a minute, man. Anytime that we're out with someone, for just accountability purposes, your license? And then once we're done with that, then we'll get you out of here, cool? Here you go, sir. Everything's good to go.
Yes,
best of luck.
Okay, so y'all just heard that right there. And shout out to Caressa for sending this story to me. I wanted to switch the picture up because this is the guy right here who was interrogated. So basically what happened was this guy was at, like you heard in the audio, he was at a ATM and he said he had forgot his PIN number. It happens. I forgot my PIN numbers a couple of times. It's scary because if you forget it too many times, you know, the machine will keep your card and then you got to call your bank and have them issue you a new card. And most likely, excuse me, a new PIN number. But then they actually had the police be called to him because they felt he was being suspicious because he was over there too long at the ATM machine. And they probably thought he was trying to use somebody else's card to try to get money out of someone else's account and whatnot. Listen, that's none of your goddamn business. It's like everything we do has some kind of level of suspicion with individuals every single time. We can't even take a shit in peace. And then, you know, they kept one thing that made me mad about this video was that terrorist, that pig going put out there who he's banking with. He said Navy Federal. Why would you tell the people what his bank is? And then I noticed, because I think they had body cam footage on, how close up to the camera they had this man's cards. Now, what gets me is the fact that it was so close to the camera that you could almost see who he was banking with. Any closer, you probably would have got access to this guy's card number, which means they could run that stuff back there. And if they wanted to, they could find a way to get into his account somehow. Somehow, some way. I swear they have no, let me not go there. And then gonna ask them like, how did he end up over in this part of town? Because you know he said he wasn't from there. He said, how did he end up over here? That's none of your damn business either. How he ended up over there. Basically insinuating that he had no right to be there. I keep telling y'all, they are no different. They are not far removed from their ancestors. And then they had three pigs terrorist there with him. He was the only guy there, and he had him surrounded by three. You had the one that was questioning him, and then you had two others standing to the side, I guess in case they felt he was going to run. But of course, somebody in the store called the cops on him because they felt he was suspicious because he was at the ATM too long. You know, I swear, like, in this establishment, a black man can't do shit. It's even as much as trying to get money out of an ATM.